in the kitchen. Murder is a sin built for speed, a mechanized intention pure as an act outside the orbit of its circumstances. Through a screen door, by a sink, her eye grinds a pistol into gunmetal flour and sifts out the pauses. Her lip crooks to the left. There is a shine in her head like scissors on kitchen formica. Past this light are imperceptibles, rest, newness, the sophisticated bitter smell of martinis. She sees it as this. Her fingers drum on a switch, one switch, and when they pull it, the elbow snaps up and the knuckles back fast as nerves. On a chair, he idles in the midday glint, blank to the minutes lurking hours from now. Here comes the panic now. What do the dogs know? On Camrose and a jumble of lots, the barking came through stucco with flowers cut into the wall. What tremor comes unheard, gathering its roll now in the hills to rush in and sway the palm trees, skinny and dour. Number one, in the mind of my mind, a hand solders motives to coils. Number two, he embraced his lawyer. Number three, geography pulls no magic on me today. Number four, in transit, pursued by his managers. Number five, over like it never was, exhausted like a dead man, he looked down and knew the red in her mouth. Number six, who was Egypt's pharaoh of the honky-tonk blues? Number seven, shoulders pushed back, it leans towards the daylight and into the eye of noon. Number eight, the sultan. Number nine, the magnate. Number 10, the inscrutable DJ McMonkey. Number 11, the prime dog. Number 12, everybody needs a hook. My hook is the fez. Number 13, here comes the bliss, boy. Number 14, swank. Number 15, lies. Number 16, the hand of the unknown. Number 17, the hand of unseen sequence. Number 18, the hand of randomness. Number 19, the hand of unspeakable languages. Number 20, the calculating engine. Number 21, you're the kind of girl that would break up Van Halen. Number 22, herbal mama, 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 herbal mama. Number 23, Elliot Groffman, attorney at law, riding elephants in the mountains of Thailand. Number 24, he counted in his head, drifting as the radiator cooled. Number 25, I hope you get there. I hope you enjoy yourself. Number 26, cruel and unusual. Number 27, as the band laughed, her finger traced his spine and he folded into her. Number 28, the spiny creatures of the deep. Number 29, B is for bird who bit a boy and tore his eyes out for breaking all his toys. Number 30, under your pillow, the gun breeze. Number 31, shackled with contractual obligations. Number 32, superstars of the Hong Kong cinema. Number 33, no toy duck, fire truck. 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 Number 34, pulling gears to hear the switches click, feeling a gust of nerves. Number 35, an organ sound, chintzy, rippling, wavering towards Venus. Number 36, the runt of all numbers and the number of all runts. Number 37, lowball. Number 38, I can get with that roll of fat. Number 39, milk and cigarettes. Number 40, sin will find you out. Number 41, in the lobby, thousands of regal women from accounting, their hair in smart slants, heels stinging the floor like a rain of cutlery drumming on the Parthenon. Number 51, heart-shaped spot of blood on the back of his jacket. Number 52, the advertising girl holds a huge gun and smiles like she was taught to. Number 53, her white neck by the open door. Number 54, apparition over the World's Fair. Number 55, she had a long nose and curves as sharp as the letter X. Number 56, he watched the women, their bodies fluid in the lagoon. Number 57, the palace looked like an accordion stuck into a block of pavement. Number 58, cinema queen with a globe and a sword. Number 59, shoveling coal into the open grate. Number 60, I'll saw those suckers down. Number 61, but sleep won't come. Number 62, driving under a tangle of overpasses. A girl with a backpack on a cellular phone sighs between the exhale and the first consonant a van barrels through her. Who knows what the boy thinks, his line slipping from her voice, her words sucked backwards through the wire? 2 hours from now, he'll be drunk, his slurred thoughts slobbering over motives, why she decided suddenly to leave him and hung up mid-word. The phone yelps angrily from under a bus, and she lays splayed like an asterisk in the dreary sentence of 14th Street.
It's M. Doty of Soul Coughing and the Bug Wrangler in the Moonlight Meditations Poetry Circle on Rev 105.
He was jailed for cruelty to insects, and his agent wasn't answering the phone, so he stayed awake in the cell all night, pictures jumping around his forehead of the cops and the blow dryer they took as evidence. He used the blow dryer to force the spiders to move up the arm of a stunt woman across a floor. He was known to the industry as a professional, but he could coax wrenching performances from the crankiest bugs. He was a man famed for creating bug performances that would make people weep in the theaters. They knew what they were jumping into. He thought, I always split the money square. Am I wrong? You take some roach out of a miserable life and put it in pictures. Tame the wildest bugs with gloved hands, a flashlight, and a little blow dryer technologies. Go to the beasts and teach them respect. Take them into your home and live with them. They betray you to the police for giving them this. At a press conference, he sat at the microphone with a loyal spider whom he tried to coax a positive character statement out of, but he couldn't use the blow dryer in front of the media, and the spider stood there and said nothing while he sweated and the videotape rolled on forward. Only sex and flight lose time like this. Pop songs are curves of the same length outside the side of the clock. In this plane, above this ocean, my headphones swell with bitter melodies candied in echoplex and fattened violins, cooed at by low thrums that reshape themselves into your open mouth, your hips slithering around me. There is a tiny gap in my mind where the moan you made sat. I only remember how it felt to hear it. It comes back to me like a song I heard and loved, but that dissipated, leaving a phantom trace of notes and sequence that probably doesn't exist. I can hear the breath around it, though, and as the plane jitters through turbulence, as the melody, cupped to the side of my head like your hands did, slants towards a lush and glorious crash of cymbals and chords, your tongue stirs a weird magic into the mix. Outside the window of the plane, there is nothing, and under that, water and water and water. Only sex and flight lose time like this. Pop songs are curves of the same length outside the side of the clock. In this plane, above this ocean, my headphones swell with bitter melodies candied in echoplex and fattened violins, cooed at by low thrums that reshape themselves into your open mouth, your hips slithering around me. There is a tiny gap in my mind where the moan you made sat. I only remember how it felt to hear it. It comes back to me like a song I heard and loved, but that dissipated, leaving a phantom trace of notes and sequence that probably doesn't exist. I can hear the breath around it, though, and as the plane jitters through turbulence, as the melody, cupped to the side of my head like your hands did, slants towards a lush and glorious crash of cymbals and chords, your tongue stirs a weird magic into the mix. Outside the window of the plane, there is nothing, and under that, water and water and water.